गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इंडक्शन मोटर। इंडक्शन मोटर वर्क्स ऑन अ प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन। व्हेन वी आर गिविंग अ थ्री फेज सप्लाई टू स्टेटर वाइंडिंग, रोटेटिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड प्रोड्यूस। द स्पीड ऑफ दिस रोटेटिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज RMF इज इक्वल्स टू 120 F/P, वेयर एफ इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ सप्लाई एंड पी इज द नंबर ऑफ पोल्स। नाउ दिस रोटेटिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड will create the effect like a magnet is rotating in a space. Okay, so we have cut a part of a stator. This is the part of a stator we have cut, and this is the part of rotor. These are the rotor conductors. Now we have produced a rotating magnetic field in the stator. The direction of this rotating magnetic field is clockwise, so our rotating magnetic field is moving like this. Okay, and this rotor conductors are stationary, standing in the presence of rotating magnetic field. Now this rotating magnetic field is continuously swiping over this rotor conductor. Hence the flux associated with this rotor conductor are changes with respect to time. Hence d phi by dt is takes place, and emf e is induced inside this rotor conductor. Now we know that this rotor is a closed circuit. As this rotors are closed circuit, due to this emf, current start flowing into the conductor. And suppose the direction of this current is like going into the plane of paper, and we are showing it with this cross product as shown in this figure. Okay, so the current is going into the plane of paper, we are showing it with the cross product. Then any current carrying conductor will produce its own field, which will arrange itself in a concentric circle manner. Okay, now the direction of this field can be easily found out with the help of right hand thumb rule. So if I apply a right hand thumb rule, the direction of this rotor field is, I will get a clockwise as shown in figure. Now if you observe this figure, in this whole system we have two fields. First one is rotating magnetic field, which is clockwise in direction, and second one is the rotor flux or rotor field, which is also clockwise concentric circle manner. So if you observe on the right hand side, both the fields are in same direction. Okay, so this two fields are getting add up on a left hand side to produce high flux density area, whereas if you observe the right hand side of this system, the rotating magnetic field direction is upward and rotor flux direction is downward. So they are in opposite direction, they cancelled out and produce the low flux density area like this. So on the left hand side there will be high flux density area, on the right hand side there will be low flux density area. And we know that these are the flux lines. This flux lines acts as a stretch elastic membrane. So this flux line exerts the force or the push on this conductor from left hand side to right hand side, and this conductor will get push forward. Now this same happened with the second conductor, with the third conductor, and your rotor starts moving. So in this way your induction motor starts. So this is the whole explanation of working of induction motor. In the next lecture we will discuss the principle of slip and how it works. Thank you.